Hi children, how are you all? I hope you are fine. So today you're going to go through a story, The Lion and the Mouse. Have you ever heard the story, The Lion and the Mouse? Okay, the most of them have heard the story, isn't it? So we just take out the worksheet and take page number 87 and we can go through the story, The Lion and the Mouse. The Lion and the Mouse. Okay. So when I am reading, you have to point out each line, each word with your finger. Okay? And then I'll show some pictures related to our lesson, to our story. So you'll get more idea about it. Okay, children? The Lion and the Mouse. A lion fell asleep in the forest with his head resting on his paws. Look at the picture. A lion fell asleep in the forest with his head resting on his paws. A timid little mouse came upon him unexpectedly and in her fright to get away ran across the lion. A timid means easily frightened. Easily frightened, a little mouse came upon him. Unexpectedly means without expecting, without knowing. And in her fright to get away, when he saw the lion, he got scared and to get away, ran across the lion. The lion was angry and got up from his sleep to see who was running all over him. The lion got angry and he got up from the sleep to see who was running over him, means above him. The lion laid his huge paw angrily on the tiny mouse to kill her. Okay, look at the picture. The lion laid his huge paw on the mouse to kill her. Spare me, begged the poor mouse. Spare means leave me, begged the poor mouse. Please let me go and someday I will surely repay you. Okay, the mouse said, please let me go and someday I will surely repay. Repay means payback. The lion laughed and asked, how can a mouse help a lion? After hearing this, okay, the lion laughed and asked, how can a mouse help a lion? But he was generous and finally let the mouse go. The lion was very kind, so he let the mouse to go. After some days, while chasing his prey in the forest, the lion was caught in the hunter's net. Okay, after some days, when the lion was chasing means follow, his prey means hunt and kill for food. That is the meaning of prey. Okay. While chasing his prey in the forest, the lion was caught in the hunter's net. The past tense of catch is caught. Okay. When he was follow the prey, he was caught in the hunter's net. Unable to free himself, he roared very loudly. He cannot move. So he roared very loudly. Roar means the sound made by the lion. The mouse knew the lion's voice and quickly found the lion struggling in the net. Struggling means what? Doing difficulty in the net, okay? And the mouse knew the lion's voice. He knew the lion's voice and quickly found the lion struggling in the net. Running to the ropes that bound means tied. She gnawed at it until it parted and soon the lion was free. And what the mouse done? The mouse bit. Okay. Gnawed means bite. It bit the ropes, thus the lion was free. You laughed when I said I would repay you, said the mouse. Now you see that even a mouse can help a lion. From then on, they both became good friends. Okay, the mouse said, you see, now a mouse can help a lion too. Then they became a good friends. Okay, did you understand the story? I'll tell the story one more time. Okay, The lion fell asleep in the forest with his head resting on his paws. A timid little mouse came and he ran over him. Okay? The lion got angry and he got up from the sleep. And what he has done? He laid his huge paw on the mouse to kill. So the mouse said, "Please leave me. Someday, surely I will repay you." So after hearing this, the mouse asked, "How can a mouse help a lion?" Okay? But the lion was very kind, so he let the mouse to go. So after some days, when the lion was chasing his prey, he was caught in the hunter's net. He cannot move. He was struggling in the net. He was roaring in pain. By hearing this, the mouse realized that is lion sound, and he ran and came. And what he has done? He bit the ropes. Thus the lion was free. And then the mouse said, "Even the mouse can help the lion too." Thus they became the good friends. And what is the moral of the story, children? What is the moral of the story? A kind deed is never forgotten. Children, if you get a chance for helping anyone, surely you have to help them. So when you need a help, they will help you too. Okay, children? So that is the moral of the story. Now, shall we read the lesson one more time? You just keep your finger under each word and repeat after me. The lion and the mouse. A lion fell asleep in the forest with his head resting on his paws. A timid little mouse came upon him unexpectedly and in her fright to get away ran across the lion. The lion was angry and got up from his sleep to see who was running all over him. The lion laid his huge paw angrily on the tiny mouse to kill her. "Spare me," begged the poor mouse. "Please let me go, and someday I will surely repay you." The lion laughed and asked, "How can a mouse help a lion?" But he was generous and finally let the mouse go. Some days later, while chasing his prey in the forest, the lion was caught in the hunter's net. Unable to free himself, he roared very loudly. The mouse knew the lion's voice and quickly found the lion struggling in the net. Running to the ropes that bound him, she gnawed at it until it parted, and soon the lion was free. "You laughed when I said I would repay you," said the mouse. "Now you see that even a mouse can help a lion." From then on, they both became good friends. Moral: a kind deed is never forgotten. Now we can read one more time. Okay, are ready? Just read louder. The lion and the mouse. Repeat after me. A lion fell asleep in the forest with his head resting on his paws. A timid little mouse came upon him unexpectedly and in her fright to get away ran across the lion. The lion was angry and got up from his sleep to see who was running all over him. The lion laid his huge paw angrily on the tiny mouse to kill her. "Spare me," begged the poor mouse. "Please let me go, and someday I will surely repay you." The lion laughed and asked, How can a mouse help a lion? But he was generous and finally let the mouse go. Some days later, while chasing his prey in the forest, the lion was caught in the hunter's net. Unable to free himself, he roared very loudly. The mouse knew the lion's voice and quickly found the lion struggling in the net. Running to the ropes that bound him, she gnawed at it until it parted, and soon the lion was free. You laughed when I said I would repay you, said the mouse. Now you see that even a mouse can help a lion. From then on, they both became good friends. Moral: a kind deed is never forgotten. Children, I hope you understood this story. What I have to do is you have to read thrice. Okay? Make it understand and read. Okay? And see you in the next class. Bye.